Hello there. Good morning from Proactive New York. With me today is Klee Irwin, CEO at Irwin Naturals. Klee, good to see you again. How are you?
Oh, it's always good to be here with you and talk with you, Christine. I'm good. Thank you.
Always good to see you as well. Exciting news today. The company announced it's looking to acquire the assets of New England Ketamine, which is a clinic in New Hampshire. What did you like about this specific location?
Well, I mean, they serve patients in Connecticut, Maine, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, as you mentioned, Rhode Island and Vermont. So we really like that hub to service people who really need it in the New England region. You know, it's you've famously heard about, cities like Seattle that have a lot of, cloudy days and a lack of sunshine, and that maps to the rates of depression. And so you have that sometimes in a lot of the cities in the New England area as well. So people there really need this. They're grateful for it. There's a lot of veterans also, in that area with PTSD. So we're so excited to get, a group as established in that community and being excellent operators as our partners at New England Ketamine. So very, very important part of the world and really a lucky team up that we bumped into those folks.
So how soon now do you think Irwin can come in and retrofit the clinic and then begin treating patients here?
With our roll up, we're only acquiring clinics, ketamine clinics that are already set up and ready and are doing business. They have to be profitable. If we make an exception on profitability, they better be very close to profitability and months away, from making money. But with respect to we don't really need to retrofit and set them up, but we do need to go in and change the name, right? The sign. We need to, systematize the other back end things, like we do centralized insurance billing, from one headquarter location. And those things are pretty straightforward. It's a check, punch list. But from day one, we'll be benefiting from their revenues and they'll be operating.
So how is the roll-up going? You did give guidance in your last earnings call of looking to bring in around $56 million in EBITDA by 2023 attributed to the roll-up. So tell us how that's going.
So we did our earnings call last week and, as a lot of our investors know, we're an anomalous company in our space because, most companies in our space, of ketamine and cannabis lose money. Really all of the public ones that I know of lose money and we make a lot of money, but in the CPG space where our business started in 1994, most of those competitors selling, packaged goods, herbal health products, they lose money some years in their history, especially the beginning years, but not us. We've had a contiguous run of 28 straight years of profitability. So I only say that to brag about how proud we are of the earnings call announcement that we broke our 28-year record in terms of profitability. So our adjusted EBITDA was 12 million. And this year, it'll be a lot higher, but we didn't disclose what that number is. So I can't disclose it to you, but I can disclose to you what next year will be because we put out that information in a press release. It'll be 56 million projected, right? EBITDA profit next year, and then 112 million in EBITDA profit the following year. So that is a very, very, and so you can kind of speculate on your own what, if we did 12 million last year and 56 next year, you can kind of fill in the blanks and speculate what you think this year will be. But I can tell you that this year, we intend to severely beat last year's numbers. And so anyway, all of that growth comes a little bit from our core original legacy business. It grows but it's a very mature brand, known by maybe 80% of households, over 100 million people. And And so it doesn't, it's not a rocket in terms of year over year growth, because it's so mature. So that, you know, that kicks in growth, like it always does. And then the cannabis licensing also kicks in growth. But these numbers that I described to you are just surging rockets of vertical growth. And that is driven by the roll-up of the ketamine clinics, because at the end of the day, what we're doing is inorganic growth, right? It's not like we're creating that business. We're finding partners that we are impressed with, and we're essentially buying their profit. We're merging with them, but if they make $2 million a year profit and we merge with them and give them some of our stock, it's kind of like buying their profit with our stock. And we can buy that profit as fast as we can crank out contracts, because it's not the same as moving heaven and earth to build a brand new clinic. So that's how we get up to these outrageously higher profit numbers. And it's really a strategy where it's first come, first serve. So we're picking clinics that are profitable, that we like the ethics of the owners. And if they want to join us, they can join us. If they don't, it's not a problem, because most of the clinics we've spoken to are interested. We have 50 clinics right now in our mergers and acquisitions pipeline at one stage or another. We have another 150 that we're at a much earlier stage of contacting. And we have a total of about, you know, maybe 4,500 mental health clinics and also clinics specializing in ketamine mental health treatment, you know, which is a psychedelic, to acquire or merge. So the roll-up actually goes on for a number of years. So it's interesting. I mean, this stock market and this world environment is kind of unprecedented, because we've got these two back-to-back years of 8.5% inflation, which is unprecedented in our lifetime, or for many decades. And then that usually is going to mean that all the money that would have formerly been in bank accounts, government bonds, CDs, commodities, has to come out and look for something that will beat 8.5%, right? Return, to beat the inflation. And normally that's going to send money into higher risk stocks that can give you a higher return, you know, like biotech or tech, but that comes with risk. And what's going on now is people don't want risk, because there's a war in Europe and COVID kind of scares people, and you know, the thing with China's housing collapse. So it's interesting, because where does the money go if people are head shy about putting their money into higher risk stocks that can have higher returns, and yet they can't, because of inflation, they can't put their money in safe risk stocks because they have to beat 8.5%. So that's where we come in. So we are a growth stock, but because it's a simple roll-up play, it's very straightforward. We're profitable, so we self-fund it. It's based on stock, so we really don't need a lot of cash to do the roll-up, even if we pay some clinics cash sweeteners. And if you really look for the fly in the ointment, there are not the typical amounts of things that can go wrong, right? Or speculative risk that would ordinarily be in a growth stock that's having projections like 56 million profit next year. So we think we're that Goldilocks bowl of porridge, right? Where the risk is low and the return is high because the growth is high.
Right. Look forward to following your strategy here. Klee, thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Talk to you next time, Christine. Bye-bye.